Good your good evening and welcome to Spotlight. With me tonight, the president of Macomb County Community College, Dr. James Sawyer. Dr. James, welcome to MEA.
Well, thank you, Wally. It's a real pleasure to be here with you today.
Thank you. Doctor, this is the first visit here, and we want you to introduce yourself to the community. Where do you grow up? Which school do you went?
Sure, absolutely. So I was actually born in Connecticut. My dad was in the Navy. So, but my family's from Michigan, so I was back to Michigan by the time I was 6 months old.
Oh.
So I grew up in Detroit until 1976, and then my family moved to Sterling Heights.
Yes.
My dad worked in Troy at the time, so it was closer to work. I went to Utica High. I graduated from Utica High, and so I'm a proud Utica chieftain.
Yep.
I lived in Macomb County since 76, so many years. I went to Lawrence Tech for my mechanical engineering degree.
Good school.
Very good school.
They have not a very good president, too.
They absolutely do.
Dr.
Sabah is very, he's a friend, and he's doing great work at Lawrence Tech, for sure.
Yes.
And then I went to Central for my master's and doctorate degrees.
Oh, good. They advertise with us, too.
Okay, good. Sure. Yeah. And I've lived in Sterling Heights, Clinton Township, and now I live in Chesterfield Township and New Baltimore.
I see. When you become the president of Macomb County?
I became president in July of 2017.
2017.
Yeah, I've been at the college since 2002.
I see.
And I started as the dean in engineering advanced technology. Then I was provost for a number of years.
Is that what your doctor degree?
My bachelor's in mechanical engineering.
Okay.
And my master's in is administration, and my doctorate's in educational leadership.
I see. So you've been what, 8 years?
Mm-hmm. 7 years.
Tell me more about Macomb County. Where is the campus? How many buildings we have? And more important, we're going to come later, what they teach.
Sure.
So tell me about the...
So we're excited to be celebrating our 70th anniversary next year. So we've been a very important community resource for a number of years.
That's it.
We've got two large campuses, one on 12 Mile in Warren.
Okay.
The other one's on Hall Road in Clinton Township. Both campuses are comprehensive campuses, we call it. We do all of our general education. We specialize in our engineering and advanced technology programs at our South Campus and our health programs at Center Campus. We have business and IT on both campuses. So in addition to that, I mentioned we have our East Campus that's located on Dunham Road near the county jail. And there we do our police, fire, emergency management training.
That's great. That's my first time knowing about
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah, and in fact,
I thought they have to go to specialist school for that.
Yeah, no, we're to do that, and very important resource for the community. And if you have an interaction with a police officer or a firefighter, there's a very good chance they've come from Macomb Community College. So we're very, very proud of those programs. And then we have a training facility on Van Dyke. We call it an MTech. That's the short name for it.
Uh-huh.
And there we do a lot of advanced technical training as well. A lot of robotics, controls, automation, those types of programs.
I see. So when you go to I went to Oakland University, you know, OCC first and then.
Well, I'm glad you went to OCC, so you know what a community college
exactly,
is like.
Exactly, absolutely. But I know at that time, a long time ago, I took courses. I didn't study to go to school to graduate from that school. Is that how it is? A student after he graduates from high school, before he go to college, he enroll in community college. And tell me how the system works.
Okay, sure, absolutely. We offer the first 2 years of a degree program. So if you go to a community college, you can earn an associate's degree. But many students come to us just to take courses that will then transfer to their bachelor's degree. We have a number of what we call transfer agreements with area colleges, really all throughout the state. Our students primarily transfer to Oakland University or Wayne State University.
Nice.
And we've got agreements so that whatever they take in Macomb transfers to those schools. So we have full programs now, Wally, in terms of you can earn an associate's degree in a particular field, be it law enforcement, business, IT, our nursing programs. We have many different health programs.
Oh, you have nursing programs?
We have nursing, respiratory therapy, occupational therapy.
Wow.
Physical
I
therapy.
Didn't know about
oh,
that,
yeah,
honestly,
absolutely. Yeah. It's,
yeah.
So again,
it's complete,
we're
honestly, college.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
No, we're a full fudge college. We've
yes.
got over 30,000 students annually.
Wow.
We're the largest community college in terms of enrollment in the state of Michigan.
I see.
So it's very, very robust programming. Really, in just about any field you might be interested in, you can start with us. You know, our faculty are very adept at meeting students where they're at. You know, community colleges, unlike universities, we take everyone who comes to us. We consider ourselves open access.
Yeah, we don't go by scores and
no,
all that.
No, everyone's welcome. We bring them in, and we try to do whatever we can to help them be successful in whatever their goal is. For some students, they want to just take some training programs, take some courses, and get a job. Mm-hmm. Others want to take courses and then transfer to a four-year, and others want to earn an associate's degree. So we're there to do all of that.
Okay. Dr. Sawyer and the government, our government, support that anytime. And see, she support the community college, but always talk about training school. It's sad to say, but in many urban area, we see the young people, they graduate from school, and then nothing. And you see them wasting their time and all that. But for training school, a lot of them, they like that, especially if he's good in electronic, in engineering. And you have now the artificial intelligence, mm-hmm. and all the young people, they want to get courses about computers and all that. Do you have that?
Yes, we do. And
okay. Tell me
it's
more
a great,
about
it's a, yeah,
this
it's a great
important for a lot of people who, you know.
Okay, yeah, no, it's, but Wally, I will tell you, we need to change the thinking because it is like college. It's any post-secondary training is valuable. So to your point, there's a lot of great jobs in the skilled trades.
Absolutely.
And we've got full skilled trades. You think of the construction trades, carpentry, plumbing, electrical, that sort of thing.
Sure.
We're very active in the trades with the large employers as well. Mm-hmm. For millwrights, pipe fitters, electricians, those types of things. So, it's a great career path for people who don't maybe want to earn a 4-year degree. They just want to take some courses that's going to prepare them to get a job. The skilled trades are a fantastic way to do that. In fact, we just opened up our new skilled trades advanced technology center this fall. It's a $45 million building that opened, really revamped all of our programs.
Yes.
You know, you talked about artificial intelligence. You know, it's really that convergence of technology today that students need to learn about.
Absolutely.
And this facility was really designed and built to really help us foster that type of environment for students.
I see. Okay, Dr. Sawyer, a lot of professional people who graduate 10, 15 years ago, but he want to update himself. If it's engineering, if it's med, if whatever, you know, mm-hmm. he want to come and update. Do you have this kind of courses?
Absolutely. No, we do a lot of what we call it customized training, Wally, where employers contract us to do specific training for their employees.
But individual, can he come?
Yeah, we offer open enrollment type courses in our continuing education area that can prepare people for jobs, be them entry-level healthcare careers like certified nurse assistant or phlebotomists, those types of entry-level jobs. And our hope and goal is to have them continue to pursue education and take jobs with increasing levels of responsibility.
Absolutely, because he's going to update himself. You
exactly.
know, the
exactly.
information he's got 15 years ago, today with the technology we have, you know, he has to get all the new technology.
Absolutely. No, and one of the, I mean, we're very advanced technology. One of the programs we're very proud of is with General Motors. We do their automation and controls training worldwide. That's done out of our MTech facility. You know,
that's
we do
big.
That virtually for them, but it gives you a sense of the level of competence we have in terms of that training. If you walked into our MTech facility, mm-hmm. you would think you're in a factory. We've got, you know, automation just like if you were in a factory doing automotive parts, for example.
Wow.
So it's a very high-tech environment, and in those programs in particular,
and we need it in these
absolutely.
Days of technology.
And those programs, for example, you can take a 14-week program in controls and automation and go out and get a job. And we have students who do that. And it's a 14-week commitment, but it's a pathway to an outstanding career.
I see. Dr. Sawyer, is there some courses online
we
that
do.
They could take it, even people outside Michigan?
Yeah, correct? We do. We do a lot online, a lot virtually. About half of our enrollment is virtual.
Okay.
Some courses are more adapt to that than others. You know, certain courses need to be hands-on. You want a nurse who touches people, right?
Exactly.
Who just touches.
Sure.
We have a lot of simulation, mannequins, those
but
sorts of things.
But there's people that want to update themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So take courses in engineering and whatever, you know,
mm-hmm.
to update himself. That's 14 weeks. he'll have knowledge of today,
yeah,
not 15 years ago.
But that particular program, you have to be on ground because you're touching the robots and doing the automation. So it really depends on the curriculum, Wally, but we do have a number of opportunities virtually for people to continue training and really pursue degrees. You can earn a degree completely online in business, for example.
Okay. Do you have Dr. Sawyer? Dr. Sabah was here and he said the students who come, he guarantee a future, guarantee a very good job, pay good pay.
Yeah.
Do you have that?
Well, I won't call it a guarantee, Wally, but
is the corporation come to you the last semester and they want to recruit those students?
Yes, that happens in the continuing education programs, the workforce programs I talked about in particular. And I think, you know, the data is very, very clear. I mean, your lifetime earnings are much, much higher with a credential, some sort of training, some sort of degree. Your unemployment is much less. You're much more employable if you have those skills. So while there's no guarantee, it really does provide that pathway to a good career and a good job and, you know, family sustainable wages. We want our students to be able to provide for themselves and their family, and that's good for the whole community.
Absolutely. Good for the economy.
Absolutely.
And one of the reasons I ask you this, we know we broadcast in every state in the nation, you know, and there's a lot of students, a lot of professionals interested to update themselves. So if they could possibly take that course online, that will help a lot.
Absolutely. No, we have that. And again, those courses transfer to other degree programs. One program, you know, given your focus in media like you have, we have a program called Media and Communications Arts. And we do fantastic work in there. The students are very in very high demand. They're learning all kinds of digital skills, but they're also learning broadcasting, photography, camera work. The whole
send some of them. We need them.
Yeah. No. They would in an environment like this, they would really thrive.
Yes. Absolutely. Dr. Sawyer, give me 2 minutes. Why? And I'm asking. You know, we broadcast in every state of the nation.
Mm-hmm.
And probably there are some people that want to move to Michigan for one reason or the other. And you know, Michigan is the hub and the culture of the Middle Eastern community. And there is over 220,000 watchers every day. If he want to move to Michigan, why should he enroll in Macomb County Community College?
Well, Wally, I mean, I'm very proprietary to Macomb Community College, but I think what's special about Michigan is we have a great network of community colleges. There's 31 community colleges across the state.
Uh-huh.
And really, there's one probably located close to where you're living. And people tend to go to the one that's in their region. So we welcome students from everywhere.
Sure.
But I think it's important that your listeners and know that they can probably go to one that's close to their home as well. And we all are really good at meeting students where they're at, as I mentioned earlier. You know, we're open access. We accept everyone. You know, we've got very strong programs at Macomb, but some of the other community colleges also have strong programs. But I go back to the point I made earlier that this post-secondary training and credential is the key to success.
Yes.
And it's really going to help you get that good-paying job for you and your family.
Yes.
And it's really going to set you up for life in the future. So even if you think, you know, sometimes folks think that they're not really college material, if you will, or a degree's not for them. I really encourage them to give it a chance. And it's not as intimidating an environment as people think it is.
Yes.
Our faculty are outstanding at really trying to embrace students when they come in, figure out what's going to help them be successful, and then providing that opportunity.
Tuition, is it expensive? Because everybody, you know, think, yes, I want to enhance myself. I want to take some courses. But is tuition decent prices?
Yeah, we're very reasonable at Macomb. In fact, we're only compared to the public universities, we only cost 25% of what it costs at a public university.
Oh,
so we're tremendous value. But more importantly, Wally, there's programs now that there's a program with the state called Michigan Achievement Scholarship that pays for recent high school graduates to attend community college. And other colleges. It's a grant from the state.
Yeah.
There's another program.
That's when the governor, she talked about it and all that.
Yeah, there's another program called Michigan Reconnect for students who are 21 years and older who do not have a credential.
Okay.
They can get their tuition paid for. And then at Macomb, we're proud to offer a program called Macomb Tuition Advantage. So any student from a family who earns $70,000 or less can get their tuition paid for.
How
and that covers 57 percent of the households in Macomb County.
I see. How they could reach that?
Oh, that's available. You just come to Macomb. www.macomb.edu.
Yeah, okay.
And we, our mission folks can help walk people through
the website and the screen.
Great.
So people,
great.
You know.
Yeah, sure. We're you know, we're very proud of those programs, and we've seen our enrollment increase because of it. And you know, this winter at our commencement, we had three speakers, and two of the speakers spoke and talked about how the Michigan Reconnect program changed their lives. They couldn't afford to come back to school.
Yes, yeah.
They had the tuition paid for. They came back, and now it's just launched them into a whole new stratosphere that they just never thought was possible. So those are the things that really warm us at the college, and that's why we do what we do. It's those types of stories that really make us proud and demonstrate how we serve the community.
Great. There's about over half a million Middle Eastern community from all different Lebanese, Shia, Lebanese, Christian, Chaldean, Syrian, Egyptian, and all that. And good percentage live in Macomb County. A very good, especially in the past 10 years. And I want to tell the people all over the nation that Macomb County honestly become another hub for the Middle Eastern community. And they're close to you, and they're attending. How is the attendance from the Middle Eastern community in Macomb County Community College?
Well, you know, we don't have a census tract for that, as you're well aware. But we are seeing, I think, a growing number of students from those communities. In fact, we have a role at the college called Student Success Coaches.
Okay.
And we actually have a student success coach who specializes in Middle Eastern. She speaks a number of different dialects. And she
there
really
is
then
CASA,
becomes...
I think is a,
pardon me?
CASA. It's an organization for the student in colleges.
I'm not familiar with that.
Yeah, probably.
So I apologize.
Yeah, no problem.
But her name is Rana. She does a fantastic job, and she really becomes folks who are just more comfortable navigating initially in their native language.
Yes.
She can help kind of break down some of those barriers and get them started at the college. And of course, we have English as a second language programs to help students who
need those services.
Uh-huh. And you know, we're very excited to welcome those folks to our college.
You know, doctor, we have different culture. The way we talk, they like to talk to their people. And sometimes, you know, students at large, they're gonna see this, they don't like it and all that. So we need to somebody understand their culture, somebody start the way they live and the way they act and all that.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have somebody in your school to understand that, that'd be great. Yeah.
Yeah, no, and Rana does a very good job of that. But I think, you know, I go back to our faculty being very good about that, right? Trying to engage students in the learning. And I think community colleges are really particularly good at that, Wally, because we bring in students from all different backgrounds. You know, we've got students from very modest means to their high school valedictorians. It really runs the gamut. If you go to a specialized university, you're going to get really good students, very high achievers. Well, frankly, some of our students didn't do very good in high school, but this is a second chance.
Exactly.
This is a chance for them to get engaged.
Yes.
In many cases, they find something that they're interested in, they're excited about, and it's a whole new ballgame for them.
You know, my advice to all the students, if you graduate from high school, some of them, they don't have the money or they don't have the will, you know, to go to college, four-year college and all that. This is your opportunity. Community college is your opportunity. You want to enhance yourself? You want to prepare yourself to go to college? Go to community college.
Absolutely. And really, to your point, Wally, the finances are not an issue. The majority, you know, students who come from low-income backgrounds can go for free. And, you know, that's something to really, as much as we try to get that word out there, that's a hard message to convey, right? People tend to be, well, come on, it can't be for free, or, you know, they just are a little skeptical, if you will. But that's the message. If you're under certain income thresholds, typically around $70,000 for the family, then you qualify for a significant amount of aid, both from federal, state, and even from Macomb Community College.
Yes. And you know, Dr. Sawyer, COVID created a lot of problems. You know, some of the spouses lost job. Liquor increased 25%, you know, drinking. Most of the kids, instead of they being in the school playing with their friends and all that, they are in one room watching social media and getting mental health problems. Do you have in the school in general that issue and how you deal with it? One is mental health problem. Second, using the drugs.
Well, I think I agree, Wally, that mental health has really become a crisis. Yes. It's something we worry about greatly on campus. We have seen an increase in incidents. We're very excited. Just recently, we entered into an agreement with a company called UWill. And UWill will provide our students 24/7, 365 days a year counseling. Because we just didn't have the resources to be able to do that. So we've contracted with this firm, who's doing it with a number of colleges and universities across the country. And we've only been doing this now for about 6 weeks. So far, it's going very well. The feedback from the students who participated has been good, because it really is important to give students that immediate attention, right? If there's a crisis, we want to interact as soon as we can.
And doctor, you see all the shooting.
Oh, yeah.
It's all from mental health.
Yeah.
That's how it built on them. And go ahead.
Yeah, absolutely. So that's why that intervention early on is so important. So that's something, pardon me, that we're excited that we're able to provide our students. It's a great service. The drug use,
yes,
we don't really see that on campus, Wally, to be frank. Mm-hmm. But one thing we did start in partnership with FAN, Families Against Narcotics, we have a Narcan dispenser on our campus. So no questions asked. You go there, it's free. Take it. Uh-huh. The chief of police updated me recently. I think we've had about 200 kits pulled out of there. So
that's good. You know,
that's good.
You know, just in case, you know.
Just in case. Yeah. It's
you know, a lot of student doctor, and sad to say, there is one incident that happened in Dearborn. A lot of school, they thinking of taking this drugs, it helped them to stay late and study and all that. But they don't know, and this stupid drugs, there is so much chemical that could kill you. And one of the students, he's got a few months to graduate from med school, and his mother, she's a doctor, his father is an attorney, and they see him at the CVS store in the parking lot, dead, taking the drugs. Imagine.
It's just a crisis. It's so sad when you hear stories like that.
It's happening everywhere. We hear about it because we're media, you know.
Right, right. Yeah. No, it's very, very sad. And I think society-wise, Wally, that dealing with these mental health crises, particularly for our young people, I think is very, very important and something we really need to focus on as a society.
Yes. And thank you so much for all the service you've been doing.
Well, thank you.
Honestly, you give me a lot of information that I never know about it. And I'm close to you guys. You know,
right.
I'm in Macomb County.
Well, and you know, that's the, you know, we as much as we try to share, we that's the reality sometimes, right? And until people think about or have a need, they don't think about us or recognize us. But we do the best we can to try to get the word out, so we truly appreciate opportunities like this to share our story. And again, we've been an indispensable community resource for 70 years. And
I know
we're proud of graduates. You know, we were talking earlier, Mark Hackle's a graduate of Macomb.
Guy.
We're proud of Mark.
Good friend.
Sheriff Wickersham. And there's numerous others. Mm-hmm. County Prosecutor Pete Lucido. So a lot of Tony Forlina, the clerk, as well.
They
so a lot of the
here.
Politicians.
They all came here.
They went through.
Rocco and Tom. You know, they all come here.
I never thought about it that way, but we've had them all kind of go through the college over the years, which is fantastic. That's who we're there to serve. We're the community's college.
Yes.
We're there to serve everyone, no matter what their level of expertise is or knowledge. Come to Macomb, and we're going to help you be successful.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Dear viewers, that was my interview with Dr. James Sawyer, Macomb County Community College. And honestly, you hear the doctor about so many programs they have. You know, if you want to be a fireman or a police officer, you could take the courses there. If you want to be engineering, you could take the courses here. If you want to be nurses, med, anything. And if you want to update yourself, a lot of professional, you know, they graduate 10, 15, 20 years ago. And they don't have knowledge about what happened today, all technology today. You could enroll one of the courses in Macomb County, and that will help you tremendously. For the kids that they graduate from high school, and probably the family cannot afford to send to college, or for some other reason, you have Macomb Community College. You could take courses for a year, for a few months, for 2 years, and that will help you. We get you ready to go to college, and that's your future. Another thing, the training school. Don't forget that. A lot of kids sitting at home and doing nothing. You know what? A lot of you, probably you like artificial intelligence, or you like electrician, or you like plumbing. there's courses in Macomb County you could go and take, and that, believe me, after you take that and have certificate, you could make money more than the people graduate from college. So please discover Macomb County Community College, and you're gonna see so much opportunity there to enroll. And especially for the people from outside Michigan, from outside Macomb County, and from outside Michigan, please, if you have in mind to move to Michigan, don't forget, check Macomb County website, Macomb County Community College website, and you're gonna see a lot of things that for you and your children to enhance your education and get you to be more effective in the world economy. Thanks for watching, and good night.